Hey YouTube, this is Collins Customs Garage here. Sorry, I haven't posted a lot of videos on the F100 today, or not today, but here lately. I've been doing more and more and more and more work with my little garage shop, doing a lot of mobile mechanic stuff. Kind of ties up a lot of my time. I get home, I gotta be with the kids, the wife, so on and so forth. But I have found out that that thing over my shoulder does not make the greatest mechanic vehicle. It works and it does the job, but when you take a 2017 Explorer and you turn the trunk into a toolbox, it's not the greatest thing in the world. But I did purchase me a truck. Okay, I'm actually leaning on it right now and I'm getting ready to show y'all. I got a really good deal on it. It's a 93 F250 with a 7.3 in it. Now, before you go and thinking power stroke, it's not. It's naturally aspirated. But it only has 150,000 miles on it. I bought it. It has a couple issues to be worked out. Initially, we thought it was a flex plate. That was bad. It wasn't a flex plate. I'm going to insert that clip right. All right, now that that clip is over and you see what I'm dealing with now, I'll give you the walk around on the truck. Alrighty, we'll start at the back. Bumper's fucked up, but hey, it is what it is. 250, it's got some rust, but this bed is coming off and I'm putting a flatbed on it. Seat is horrible. It is what it is. Dashboard's in relatively 93 F250 dashboard shape. As you can tell, that needs to be replaced, fixed. The only rust that I have to fix on this whole thing is right here, and I'll show it to you from the bottom. But it's not bad. Already got a floor plan on order from Rock Auto. I'm just waiting until payday to order it. All right, and there you go. It's a 7.3. Batteries are out. This fender well is out. I've got the fender well. I just got to put it back in there. But radiator's fairly new. Tires are fairly new on, or fairly good on this thing. And it's got the Mickey Thompson wheels on it. And yes, it is missing a couple lug nuts, but here's where we're at right now. Got the drive shaft dropped, but I also got the transmission dropped. Starter's over there hanging, and as you can tell, there is the back of the crankshaft, the remain seal. So, with that being said, this bed is getting a flatbed put on it. I'm putting a gooseneck hitch down in back there. Oh, and there's the front bumper, by the way. I'm gonna build one. I'm gonna use those brackets, weld a bar in there, keep the brackets where they're supposed to be at. And I'm gonna weld, I'm gonna make a new bumper for the front. But with that, this bed, like I said, it's coming off. This toolbox, I'm just gonna pull out the stuff that's bent and stuff like that on it, like you can tell. Those stickers are coming off because, for one, I'm not a Marine. I was Army, so that's definitely coming off. But this toolbox, I'm gonna repair what I can on the toolbox, hopefully be able to reuse it. If I can't, I can't. I'll just go get another toolbox. Not too big, I got it for free, and then I can always use this diamond plate for something else and make covers and so on and so forth. Be really cool about it. But one thing you can tell is the exhaust on this thing. It's 4 inch from the Y pipe where it comes together. It's 4 inches all the way back. Manual bend over the axle and out the back. Like I said, I got a really good deal on this truck. I'm glad I got this truck, because when it's all said and done, it's gonna be my work truck. So look forward to putting videos of this thing up on YouTube. The F100 is going to take a back burner, back seat for right now, and that's only because I've got to get this truck up and running so I can go make money with it and stop putting the miles on that thing. So I don't want to keep putting miles on that. It's working for right now. Now if I got to go take a job that puts me further out where I'm charging X amount of money more as a service fee, then yeah, I'll drive that. But for the most part, my goal is to drive the old 7.3 International F-250 on my jobs. This video is not very long. It's just a heads up of where I'm at. I do have some things that I was able to do on the F-100, but it's pretty much cease and desist on that and jump on this. So as soon as my paycheck hits from these last couple of jobs where I use PayPal, I don't suggest using PayPal, but as soon as that clears, I'm going to order my parts, and all of my parts should be here within a week and a half, maybe 2 weeks at the most. But since I've got the transmission down and I've got the transfer case down, I'm going to also rebuild both of those items myself. Rock Auto sells the rebuild kits, but I found a better rebuild kit for both of them on eBay for cheaper with no shipping. So I'm going that route. And I bought the manual to show me how to do it. I probably won't do a video when I do that, only because it's the first time doing it, and I don't want to have to worry about hitting the camera, not listening, so on and so forth. Like, I want to be able to concentrate on what I'm doing. So I will show you the before and after. Well, you've seen it before. The after will be when the sun gun goes back up in the truck. But with that being said, I hope y'all have a very great day. It's Sunday here. It's almost 1 o'clock, which means NFL is coming on, which means my Washington football team is going to be playing. And they play the Carolina Panthers. And I live in the great state of North Carolina and this nice Carolina blue sky. So I don't root for the Panthers. I've always rooted for Washington back when they were the Redskins. They're still the Redskins to me. You don't like that, I'm sorry, but not really. But that's where I'm at. And I'm going to enjoy some football, enjoy my family. And once that game is over, I'm going to get out here and start extracting bolts. So I hope y'all have a very wonderful day. And that is all for Collins Customs Garage.